So here we are back, and I'm going to show you how to develop to your Windows PC with Manjaro Linux XFCE. I've already downloaded the Windows Manjaro Linux ISO file from the previous video I showed about the review of Manjaro Linux, and this is the Manjaro XFCE 17.0.1 stable version. This 1.5 GB in size. So in order to boot up your image, first you need to write the ISO file onto your USB device or your DVD, CD, anything. So if you want to just write it onto your CD, you can right click on your ISO file, then you can burn the disk image directly from your Windows file manager. If you want to use a USB stick, you can download a Rufus, R-U-F-U-S, or a unit booting program. This helps you to write your ISO files onto your USB device. So I'm using unit booting. Double click on the download file. Yes, and this small window pops up where you can select your disk image. I'll choose the ISO image from my file manager. Just select the ISO file. Select your USB device number, click OK, and the USB will be returned with your ISO image file. So that's it, and now let's go and boot up the ISO file we just burnt. So go ahead and restart your PC, and this time when you do it, make sure you get into the BIOS menu. I'm showing this in my virtual box. You can install the Manjaro ISO file in your real hard drive. I'm using the EFI boot mode, which is used by Windows 10 and Windows 8 PCs, so you will have no trouble installing it on a real hard disk. So I'm just setting my ISO file to boot up first. Yes, it is booting up first, and the EFI mode is enabled, so let's start. And this is the Manjaro Linux welcome screen. Just select from CD, DVD, ISO the option. If you have NVIDIA drivers, you probably need to make this option non-free. I am doing this in my VirtualBox, so I don't have any problem with that. You can select the keyboard layout, language, anything you want, and let's also time zone. So let's go ahead and click on CD option. So this will show you the Manjaro Linux starting splash screen. So my Manjaro Linux has booted up, and it is recommended that you have a stable internet connection, because if you are having an AMD processor or NVIDIA graphics card, you'll probably need the Manjaro Linux to try and run the MSWD program, which will install the required softwares automatically. So I've already given a brief idea of what Manjaro Linux is and how to use the Pacman package manager, and also the PaMac GUI front end of Pacman. So let's go ahead and click install Manjaro Linux. If you want to see the previous video, you can always check in my channel. And here is the Manjaro Linux installer. It's the Calamaris installer which is used here. Connect your device to the power source. Make sure it doesn't boot off while doing this, and select your preferred language here. Click next. You can choose your location wherever you belong to. If you are connected to internet, you don't have to bother with that. I am living in India, so I am selecting Kolkata. Time zone will be in Kolkata. You can set your default language, set the date, anything like that. Click next. Select your keyboard layout. If you don't know what layout to choose, adjust the default work for you. But if you want to try it another keyboard layout, you can always do that from here list. Click next. Now if you are going to dual boot with your Manjaro Linux installation with your Windows 10, you'll have to select the manual partitioning and choose the empty partition for your Windows installation, so that you can run both the Windows and Manjaro Linux. If you go ahead and click in install alongside, it will automatically search for any free space available and install Manjaro Linux, which is not recommended. If you replace a partition, it will probably replace other Linux partitions or might just replace anything else. So it's not recommended. If you erase disk, if you are doing this a fresh install, it's recommended that you erase your whole disk and start from beginning. But if you have anything like your data, music files, movie files, it will be erased completely from your disk. So I'll just show you how to manual partitioning, and this is the recommended way of doing dual boot. You can also install your system fresh from manual partitioning also. Click next. It will show the list of all available partitions, and the first four partitions belong to the Windows installation. This NTFS 30GB is the Windows main partition. So I have created a 29GB of free space. You can do this by the disk management utility available in the Windows 10 PC, or you can shrink the volume from here. Click edit and you can shrink the volume from your existing Windows partition. And I have 29GB of free space, so I'm going to create some space for my Manjaro Linux. First I'll need a 200MB, at least 200MB of FAT32 file, which will be our boot EFI. Click the ESP and the boot flag. Now this partition is required if you are going to dual boot your Windows 10 and the environment is EFI mode, UEFI mode. The older legacy version does not need this partition, but if you are booting up in the EFI, you probably need this one. Now in order to check if you are running on legacy version or the EFI version, just check it in your BIOS menu, and the chances are if you are running Windows 10 or 8, you are running mostly in EFI mode only. So this partition is very much required, otherwise the Linux partition will not be boot up. Next, I'm going to create a root partition for my device, and I'm going to choose 15GB, maybe 20GB. So 20GB, that might be it. Yes, that might be. And you can also shrink the volume from here if you wish. So I'm going to select 20GB here. It should be ext4. This is a recommended partition file system for your Manjaro Linux. You can also choose XFS, BTRFS, anything else of your choice, but ext4 is the most popular choice, and it is also a stable version. Choose the mount point as the root. Click OK. So I have a root partition, I have a boot EFI partition. Now what I need is a swap partition. Now you can choose a swap partition, double the size of your RAM, half the size of your RAM, or just the same size as your RAM. I'm going to choose this half the size, and this should work properly for everyone. Half the size is more than enough for anything. So I have a 2GB RAM in my virtual box, so I'm doing just using 1GB of Linux swap. Click OK. Now if you wish to create a separate home partition for your system, you can do it by creating a new partition, ext4, or any partition you want. I'm going to go with Butterfish and I choose home partition. Click OK. So the rest space is allocated for my home partition. If you do not do this, the whole home partition will come under this root partition, which is fine, and if you are a beginner, that is recommended. And if you are advanced user, you can also create different mount points, like the separate op partition where your external programs are stored. You can have a separate user partition where your user installation programs and user files are stored, so that next time you want to reinstall Manjaro Linux, you can retain all your user programs from here, from this mount option. And also you can also create a separate var partition, and it's up to you how you want your system to work. Now I recommend at least 20GB for your Linux system. That is the most small size that should be enough for you to work around with your Linux partition. So that's it. So click next. Choose your type in your name. Sorry, see what it is. Give any user ID, give a computer name, type in your password. Now the recommended password size as given below. It should be at least 8 characters in length and should contain letter, number and a punctuation mark, anything like that. And it is a recommended way of keeping your computer safe, but it's okay. You can choose anything you want to you are comfortable with. If you click on this option, it will automatically login you to your system. You don't have to type in your password every time you login. That's not recommended, but you can do it. Now if you click this option, that is to use the same password for your administrator account as well as the user account, it's probably not recommended. So you can keep your system safe if you have a different password for your administrator account. So if every time you want to install a package you type in sudo, so the sudo will require you to type in the administrator password, which is different from the user password. That way you can keep your system safe. But if you wish to use the same password at that, it's fine. Click next. This will show you a small summary of what you have chosen, and everything is in order and everything is fine. My Linux partition, my Windows partition is safe, and the recommended settings have been done. So click next. Now this window shows a brief idea of what Manjaro Linux is. You can go through it. Meanwhile, you can read the user guide. It has some valuable information about your Manjaro Linux system. And let the system install. So all set. This we have now installed Manjaro successfully. Now let's check if it will boot with our Windows 10 PC. And yes, success. Windows 10 Boot Manager on SDA2, and this is Manjaro Linux installed.